Now I have resurrection power, living on the inside, Jesus. You have given us freedom.
You had a nice Christmas and didn't eat too much, and you're very welcome to the service. And I would like to just wish everybody a happy new year, and we'll just come together now and prayer. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness to us, Lord. It has been a strange year, Lord. It's been a different Christmas, Lord, but we thank you that you are still the same, Lord, that you've been with us, Lord, through the highs and the lows, Lord, and you've been through with us, Lord, through the sicknesses, Lord, and the hard times, Lord. We just thank you for who you are, a God who loves us as always the same and is always there for us. So Lord, we just come before you now and we just ask for your blessing upon us as we come together to worship you. Help us, Lord, to focus on you and what you have to say to us, Lord, and let it be a blessed time and do your souls good. In Jesus' name, amen.
Save us. You came from heaven to earth. Good evening, folks. It's good to be able to share a wee thought from God's Word with you tonight. I hope you're all well. I hope you've had a lovely Christmas, a peaceful time. It's been a strange old year. I don't know how many times we've said that this past year, but it has. It's been strange. It's been different. It's been a year that I don't think any of us has ever experienced before, but I trust that you have known God's peace over Christmas. We were speaking, you know, last Sunday evening in the carol service about receiving the greatest gift of all. I don't know, I hope you got what you were wanting over Christmas, gifts and presents and different stuff, but you know, the greatest gift of all is the gift of the Lord Jesus Christ, God's only Son, and He's the one who can save you, who can fit you for heaven, can wash away your sins and can give you a new start in life. And I trust that you have received Him as your Lord and Saviour, and if you haven't, I would love to speak to you, and God would love to speak to you, far more important than me speaking to you. So all you have to do is get down on your knees, call upon the name of the Lord, ask Him to save you, admit that you're a sinner, allow Him to come into your life and wash your sins away and set you on that road that leads to heaven and leads to home. So I trust that you'll do that if you haven't already done it. And I just, God has laid a couple of wee verses in my heart I just want to encourage you with as we finish off this year, as we move into this next year. Hebrews chapter 10. I was just thinking about what would God want to say to us as we finish off this year, strange and all it has been, and we move into a new year. And I'm thinking about these two verses. God, I believe, has laid them in my heart. In Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 23 down to 25, I'll read them to you here. And it says this, this is God's word. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering. For he who has promised is faithful. And let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much more as you see the day approaching. And we know that God will bless that reading of His word. And you know, as we finish off this year and as we move into another year, the number one thing that God's saying to us there is in verse 23, He says, let us hold fast the confession of our faith. If you have asked Christ into your life as your Lord and Saviour, God's saying, hold fast and hold steady to the hope that we have in Him. No matter what's going on around us, no matter how the world goes, no matter where we're going over these next weeks and months, hold fast to the confession of faith that you have put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. Why is this? Well, He tells us in the second half of that verse, let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering. Without wavering, because we can waver a bit. You know, things can come into our life, this coronavirus, different stuff. We can waver a wee bit, but God doesn't want us to waver. He wants us to hold fast without wavering. Why is that? How can we do that? Second half of the verse tells us, for he who promised is faithful. That's the reason we can hold fast to the one who has promised. Because he is faithful. God's a faithful God tonight, folks. I want you to get that tonight. God is a faithful God. Great is thy faithfulness. O Lord, my Father, there is no shadow of turning in thee. Many things will turn and twist and waver about, but there's no shadow of turning with God. He's constant. He's the same yesterday, today, forever, never changes. That's why you and I must hold fast to the faith that we have in Him. Why? Without wavering. Why? Because he who has promised is faithful. And what does he promise to do? You know, God's word is full of promises. We need to open up this word, and he promises us so much in the word, and we need to claim the promises in God's word. I will never leave you nor forsake you. No matter what happens, he's never going to leave you. He's never going away. Your love with an everlasting love. I will supply all your needs according to my riches and glory, he says there in Philippians. He's going to supply all our needs. You're not going to go without. Yes, it might be borderline at times, but you're not going to go without. He's going to supply every need. He's going to supply everything that you need. He will give you strength. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. He will strengthen you. Them's just three wee promises from God's word. God's word is full of promises that he is going to give you rest. He's going to give you peace. He's going to give you strength. He's going to provide for your physical needs, for your spiritual needs, for your emotional needs. Whatever you need, God can provide it, will provide it, has provided it. So hold fast to our confession of faith and our confession of hope in Christ, in the one who supplies all our needs. And the greatest need he has supplied for us is he has dealt with our sin, and he has taken it away, he has nailed it to a cross, the Bible says, and he has made us right with God, he has reconciled us to God. What an amazing thing that is. Second thing I want you to think about is this, and it's in verse 24, and it says, let us consider one another. So let's read verse 24. It says, and let us consider one another in order to do what? To stir up love and good works. So right through this pandemic, from the first lockdown right through to now, I've been so encouraged that the people in Bilston Road and the people in Ballyshannon have stuck together. They've encouraged one another. They've phoned each other up. They've laid wee gifts at the door and knocked the door, wee dinners and wee different bits and pieces that they've done for each other. It's been powerful just to see that. I've been so encouraged. And we need to consider one another as we go into the new year. We'll leave this year behind and go into the new year. Continue to consider one another. That wee phone call, that wee card sent through the post or posted through a letterbox, that wee boiled cake, Nessie, that you've given me a number of occasions and different things that people have given me. It's been great. And listen, we need to encourage each other. We need to build each other up and stir each other up to good works and to love, because that's what the body of Christ, we're family. We are the family of God, and we stick together. Family sticks together, and we need to do that. So consider one another. Let us hold fast the confession of our faith. That's God. Second thing, let us consider one another. Let us look to each other. So we look to God first, then we look to everybody around us, and we make sure they're all right, and we help them out where we can. And the last thing I want us to look at is this. Verse 25, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another. So much so as you see the day approaching. What day is that? It's a day coming that Jesus is coming back. And we need to continue meeting together and being around God's word together. Tonight it's on video, it's on this wee online project. But next week, God willing, we'll be back in the hall next Sunday evening. We'll see how everything goes. But we need to keep meeting together as the family of God, encouraging each other, singing songs of praise together, looking at God's word together, praying with each other and for each other, and encouraging each other. So I just want to encourage you with these couple of verses of scripture tonight. Three things God asks us to do. Hold fast to that confession of faith. Why? Because he is faithful. God is faithful. He will get you through no matter what you face, what issues come into your life. He's going to get you through. Second thing, consider others around you. Let's always think about the people around us, and a wee phone call, a wee gift, you know, just a wee act of kindness. It can mean so much to somebody maybe that's living on their own and they're lonely. So let's consider everybody around us, and let's continue to meet as the body of Christ. If we are able to meet, let's meet as the body of Christ. Let's meet and let's sing songs of praise. Let's praise our great God together, and let's encourage each other in our faith and build each other up. And I pray as we leave this year and move into the new year that you'll be encouraged in your faith and you'll hold fast. And if you're not maybe a believer yet, that tonight's the right time to just get down. Today is the day of salvation. Get down on your knees. Cry upon the Lord. Call him into your life. Call him upon the name of the Lord, and he will save you. That's another promise that's found in his word. So until we meet again, until we talk face to face, God bless you. God bless your family. In Jesus' name, amen.
Find rest in your presence and fullness of joy. In worship and wonder I behold your face, singing what a faithful God there I. What a faithful and wonder I behold. Lord of mercy.
Folks, let's just close our time together in prayer and bring a few prayer requests to the Lord in the process. Let's all pray. Father God, we thank you tonight for your word. We pray that you would take it and you would minister it to each and every one of us, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness to us this past year. We thank you, Lord, for your hand upon each and every one of us. Some people come through difficult times. We think about Joyce and Sam Hall this year. We think about what you've brought them as a family through. And we thank you for that. And we give you thanks for them, Lord. And we pray that you would continue to keep your hand upon them. For people who have lost loved ones this year, Lord. For people who have been lonely this year. And people who have been in and out of hospital, Lord. We lift them before you. And we give you thanks for your mighty hand upon them. We thank, Lord, of Darren Smith. And we thank you, Lord, for drawing Darren to yourself, Lord, and for saving him, Lord. And we just pray, Lord, that you would continue to keep your hand upon him and pour out your spirit upon him and minister your grace to him and touch him with your healing touch, and for his family there, that you would minister and move in their lives as well, Lord. And we pray, Lord, for the Jones family, Lord, as they grieve the passing of Brian, Lord. We pray for them that you would draw alongside them, Lord. Pour out your spirit upon them, Lord. Minister and move and work and pour out your hope and your grace upon them as they grieve, Lord. We think about Patricia's dad, we think about Sharon, we think about Darren, Val's son, as they continue their treatment, Lord, that you would continue to pour out your spirit upon them and their families. We thank you for bringing Marlon through, Lord, and she was at the hall last week, Lord. What a joy it was to see her and Billy back at the hall. Lord, we thank you for each and every one, and we pray for Norma as well, as she has been feeling under the weather as well, Lord. We just pray that you would continue to pour out your spirit, Lord, upon each and every one of us, Lord. We pray for our unsaved loved ones, Lord, that you would draw them into the kingdom for such a time as this. So, Lord, just part us with your blessing tonight, Lord, as we think about you, Lord, as we think about you getting into this new year, Lord. Would you be with us in everything that we do and everything that we seek to do? May we bring honor and glory to your name. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen.